Huh?
I want you to look at face cam real quick.
Okay.
Lucky, I got drip on drip. And I'm all of the spider shit.
Okay. Bungus sponsored with the drip. James Aalaxel Reno Bungus? I mean, we're forgetting the... I think, here's the thing. This week, Pachinko was seated ninth. Ninth. I mean... Let me just report scores for a second before I talk a little bit. But look, here's the thing. We had 15 players at this weekly, and there might be more at the monthly. But let's look at the seeding. Pachinko was seeded eighth. Think about that. Do you know how many people we had above and below that? Caboose got higher. Pachinko lost to Caboose. Caboose is the 11th seed. There's such a big skill breadth within seeds. Like, 8 through, like, 12, like, any of us could take, even honestly, Chuck's 2001 sack, like at seed 13, any one of us can make a run into at least loser's top 8. And let's not even forget that Pyro showing up with the hero with some big results, getting 5th, going game 5 on Bungus, like, they are... It is crazy. And here we have more hand warmers with the age-old set of Consistent Failure versus Aalaxel. Thank you to chat. Good night. I won't say your name because as much as I respect it, I not within my personal moral conscience. No, I'll say it. Good night, gay Squidward tentacles. Good night. Y'all are what's holding down chat. Snake with the rare self-explosion SD. I'm excited to see next week. So if you didn't hear, next week, Saturday, 4 to 8, we have a monthly setup. So what that means is that it's another... We'll have a remote thing on Friday, but Saturday, in person, for all the marbles, when it gets a $60 Switch game, this is big. And usually we have some people that come out into Oberlin, like, it's pretty chill. No problem, Kede TTV. I feel like I know who you are, but I don't know who you are. So respect. But that's chill. Anyway, so we'll have a monthly. Heads up, if you're also interested in more Oberlin esports content, our league team popping off, and we're gonna have some chess stuff set up too. But anyway, this is game one in the real chess of this grand finals here. Lucas versus Snake. You have someone playing a really strong opener. Aalaxel liking the openings, trying to get a lot of early tempo beginning, a lot of downers, down tilts there. But Snake having the more consistent theory, if I were to keep the chess metaphor going, Consistent Failure and the Snake understand how to get out of know some tactics to get out a bunch of lines, to get out of some cheese openings. But right now Aalaxel with the strong opener here. Oh, it could always change. It really is just who gets the first stock. Lucky, you're probably not wrong in that the cam boxes are slightly different sizes. I did need to double check the sources, so maybe next week it'll be polished. But I don't have the time, nor do my grades can they survive if I do that. Anyway, ooh, what a wonderful Nikita fake out there. But to equalize the stocks, but. It's a lot happening here. So you notice Aalaxel changing the playstyle there a little bit, using the B button a lot more in those situations. Oh, I saw consistent failure go for that F smash, but that is not gonna work there, no siree. But see, that cipher, that high recovery, that's like castling in chess. Super safe. The only time you could ever get cheesed while you castle is if someone like just really hits you with like a queen battery. And that's what happens if you can punish such a high recovery. But not many people can punish such a high recovery. So that's why Snake's chilling. That's why Snake currently just living. He can slow down the tempo, just castle, get to a safer position, and then restart the attack. That C4 kill? That's crazy. That did 20 damage. So CF taking essentially match point in this set of RPS / chess here. It depends on if what Aalaxel can do to get back in the game here. How does he punish the high recovery? Cannot punish. Gets up aired for the trouble. Doesn't get hit by the back air. Ooh, survives. Not a good enough edge guard from Lucas there. I know, from Snake there, and now it's back to even stocks. 52%, sizable, but not insurmountable. Oh, what a catch. What a catch. That's 20% gone. That just moonwalk grenade is so menacing. Because if you're new to Smash, know that Snake's grenade hitboxes are larger for others than it is Snake. Snake has blast resistance enchantments on his chest plate. So that's why that is. Anyway. And so like that like when he just walks with the grenade, he's just a walking hitbox. It's insane. It's like Zillion in League. You just throw a time bomb on your friends and then they do the work for you. Gets up tilt, doesn't kill. I think the next one will. The next one definitely will at 101. Oh! Punishes the recovery with the correct down air. That's going to be game one in this grand finals. Why is it saying that the encoding is overloaded? This computer is supposed to be super strong. Super strength. Super speed. Game two, looks like we are going back to Pokemon Stadium 2. Pokemon Stadium 2, the true neutral chessboard of ulti stages. I think both characters really enjoy it because they have a few platforms of which they can do some jump things, some grenades with, but there's still a lot of flat land to work with. Who doesn't get the C4 hitbox to just go far enough. Aalaxel hitting a strong opening in this game. Let's see if consistent failure can just inch it out with some good neutral changes. 58%. This is almost even. Gets stuck with the C4. Now it's on consistent failure, I believe. It's really hard to track that little flashing dot. Ooh, reads it at the right time and then gets 30% recovery for his troubles. Man, imagine if chess had like a bishop, no, like a medic, that could just revive pieces. That's what Aalaxel is doing. He's playing modded chess. Cause he can like leave a piece hanging. He can lose a neutral exchange, but if he just gets a downbeat, boom, you're not losing the position. Gets hit with a PK freeze, and that's gonna be a stock. Ooh, Aalaxel just pushing this opening even further and further. Being able to trade equal with the downbeat, winning this almost war of attrition here. It's just whether James can hit consistent failure can hit a sick combo, honestly. Puts a C4 on platform. See if you remember. Oh, that's low. Doesn't get to hit the platform. So if anyone's interested in why that was a questionable recovery, as you might think, you're wrong. Lucas and Ness have the ability, if they hit stages at specific angles, they rebound with their recovery, and they're allowed to do another upbeat. So Aalaxel was banking on that angle and was hoping, but it was just cut it a little short. So a little gift for consistent failure, but 60% through and through is the current percent differential. Aalaxel doing a great job keeping center stage, but consistent failure, being patient enough, pushes out, but gets hit with a random fear for his troubles. Oh, I love the parry on the PK fire, but that is going to be stock. Aalaxel primed to take game two here. Consistent failure is going to need to get some really punch this kid in order to make it back here. Oh, reads the C4. It's probably a lot easier because I'm pretty sure the C4 detonate frame data is a little slower than Lucas's Psi magnet, making it almost a gift anytime Snake tries to activate. And that's a PK freeze, and that's game. Strong opening and strong finish from Aalaxel there. Going to Lilat, I recall last week they went to this stage as well. I think that, at least for CF, the intent is to use the triplat of Lilat, which it has a really horizontal, little tilted area there, to put more C4, to use some more explosive mind games there. But I remember last week we also saw that for Lucas, that the same almost held, that it's harder to come at Lucas from above, especially when he's throwing out them PK fires and them PK freezes. So let's see who makes the quicker adaptation and changes the opening. Slower gameplay on Lilat, definitely not surprising, especially given the platform and the blast zones of Lilat. Lilat, I believe, at least the triplets are already changing stuff. I forget if the blast zones for Lilat are taller on the top or closer on the horizontal, or both. Don't ask me, I don't know anything. But gets an F smash read in, that's gonna be first stock. Okay, maybe I was right that the blast zones on the side are a little smaller on Lilat. I'm not gonna have y'all confirm me because we are here watching this game. I noticed both players trying to slow down the game because they know the explosive nature of Lilat can mean that Either competitor can take a stock almost immediately. Oh, C4 is again hitting himself. 106 to 61. For Aalaxel, I would say that 61 is not early percent. He's been getting very successful getting a grenade or getting a C4 off the down B. So he's essentially, honestly, I find at effectively 33%. That's a back throw and that's death. Even stocks, essentially 30% difference here. How does consistent failure push lead? Gets an F tilt with the parry. Parry essential with the frame data here. Because Aalaxel can just keep throwing out hitboxes, but if you parry, you have a chance. You have a chance in. And notice, Aalaxel has minimized the lead here. Honestly, tilted it back in his favor with how he's controlling vertical space. Reads a grenade, gets percent back, and now it's really Aalaxel's court. Okay, gets the spike hitbox of Dare, but isn't able to convert. One grab versus the other grab. The other grab wins. Consistent failure looking to slow the game down a little bit. Because there you go. Because what consistent failure was looking for there is that if you can take a stock, percent doesn't matter. The stock has been taken. But as I say that, it's now last stock, even 0%. Because it's not like Lucas can recover a stock using Psi Magnet. That'd be crazy if it could. But Aalaxel with these strong early percent combos here, just pushing consistent failure already to really mid percent, where it gets a little dangerous to keep getting hit with a lot of PK fires and PK freezes. Beautiful parry. If you want to be at a grand final echelon level of skill, you must be able to consistently parry. And what we're seeing here is a masterclass in patience and in defense. Because either competitor gets an opening, they try to run a while. And especially at this last long, and this momentous game 3, this can mean everything. Clashes on the wave. I believe the Zare might have extended Lucas's hitbox there. And consistent failure trades with the down smash, and it works out. And that's game 3. And now it's Alaxel's counter pick. It seemed like the smaller blast zones helped consistent failure edge out those percent attrition battles by just being able to kill outright earlier. So it didn't have to come to the fact that both of them were at like 130% and that every single hit is going to blast them across the entire stage. Okay, they choose town and city. I like town and city. As we all know, it's Battlefield but with spicy platforms every other like minute or so. And I think at least I'm wondering how Aalaxel is interested in using these platforms other than maybe just an interest in the large blast zone of town and city. Because, I mean, let's think about it. There's more platforms. There's more places for Snake to put grenades to put C4. Or to get to stick right there. So, like, is Aalaxel going to try to use the platforms to up his mobility? Like, I don't know. I'm interested in seeing what happens. Gets a down throw C4 combo, and now it's even percent. The opener here, much more even. Looking at like a E4, D5 kind of situation. I don't know, Chess. That was a bad analogy. But consistent failure hitting the first up tilt. Grenade saving there. If that grenade did not explode at that time, Aalaxel takes a stock and then consistent failure on the back foot. Ooh. Was that a bait? Sees the grenade. Tries to trade him with the back air for the knockback. Another back air. Aalaxel on really high percent here. Ooh, isn't able to read for an up tilt or an F tilt, because now at this percent, consistent failure is going to rely on a big meaty hit, like an up tilt. Not FDA approved for kids under 13. But let's see. For as much as consistent failure took that stock, that means nothing if he cannot get a lead. If he cannot get a percent lead or a positional advantage, because right now he's in heavy disadvantage, then it's still even. And as I say that, we're still even. 13%, honestly, with Psy Magnet, nothing. Means nothing. The patience to just tilt, to just crouch and low profile the PK fire. Oh, beautiful parry. Especially against how much Lucas is just throwing out, you need to be able to parry. Cannot stress that enough. Ooh. A lot of shield by shield combat. I recall this is kind of very similar to how Fall 2020 went, when it was Aalaxel versus Karp. And while Aalaxel got the upper hand of many of time, a lot of those games are really close because they were decided in multiple. It was like 100 rock, paper, scissors matches. Who could innovate first on the shield? And I'm seeing the same thing here. But consistent failure with Snake, there's more options. And I think just more options that have minimal counterplay, at least with how ulti is designed. So as we see here, even in saying that, it's already... Oh, I shouldn't say anything. But I was about to commentator curse the stock there. with a hitbox of Psy Magnet there. Very interesting. And now the tables have turned. Aalaxel with a percent lead and essentially momentum. But Consistent Failure hits the back air. And now Aalaxel on tournament stock here. Consistent Failure about to win the second weekly. Really showing us back to his form. But I should not say anything because it's last stock game four. 10%, nothing compared to the amount that Psy Magnet is pushing Aalaxel. See, Consistent Failure is just staying there, and while you did get ultimately punished for it, that being able to stay there in center stage is very meaningful, because then they have to approach you. They are the ones in minimal space. Even stocks here, even percent, literally by a tenth of a percent. Gets it down through C4, and that's going to be it. 3-1. From our number one PR player, Consistent Failure. Showing only consistent success here. Well, that has been our weekly for you this week, folks. Thank you for watching. If you are interested in what we have, in our players, in our content, follow us on Twitch. We have another Twitch channel for other more like general esports content, Oberlin Esports Club. Look out during this semester for Smash Monthlies, league streams with our competitive league team, and a chess league, like internal to Oberlin, with what I'm aiming to have two brackets, one for ELO that is like lower than 900, and then like people that actually know what an ELO is and obviously play more. So, you come for the personalities, you stay for our too long of a stream. So, thank y'all. It is time to close up before they kick us out of Wilder. This has been P-Way, Jabroni9000, on the mic for you this Grand Finals. I wish you a warm and safe weekend.